In our program yesterday, we're looking at two people who walk right with God. Because building a love relationship with God actually means that you have decided and you have set out to walk right with God. We look at Enoch, who walked with God for 300 years after he received a warning that there was danger that was coming. We saw Noah, who, because he walked right with God, God actually decided that he was going to rescue him from the judgment that was coming. Because there is always a blessing, there's a promise. If you walk right with God, God himself will rescue you. So we're going to look at this second person, Noah, again, and the era in which he lived. In Genesis chapter 6 from verse 5, the Lord saw how great man's wickedness on earth had become. So God is a seeing God. Whatever is being done on planet earth, God is seeing. Whatever you do, God is seeing. So God saw, what did God see? God saw that man's wickedness on earth had become great. Man's wickedness was great. Man was not only wicked, but the wickedness was great. God then saw the heart of man, that every inclination of the thought of his heart was evil. Not just evil ones, but evil all the time. And that's what the problem of man is. Great wickedness, then the condition of his heart. His heart is always inclining towards evil, always thinking about evil. How did that affect God? God was grieved. God was grieved. How will you feel like if God tells you, I am grieved because of you? I am full of pain because of you. I am hurting in my inside because of you. And the Bible again says, and his heart was filled with pain. So it was a generation that was bringing a lot of pain to God's heart. A lot of pain to God's heart. Like our generation. The generation in which we are today is a generation that is living in total wickedness. All sort of wickedness that you cannot imagine, bringing pain to the heart of God. And what did God decide that he would do? God decided that he will wipe mankind whom he had created. A painful thing. God said, even though I am the one who created mankind, I did not create him to give himself to wickedness. I did not create him so that the inclination of his heart, all his thought, will be evil all the time. You were not created for wickedness. You were not created for sin. You were created to walk with God and never to bring pain to God's heart. God said, I will wipe. I believe you know what it means to wipe. It says, "For I wipe mankind from the face of the earth." Verse 8, Noah found favor in the eyes of God. Why did Noah find favor in the eyes of God? You are alive. The life you are living will bring you favor or disfavor. If you are living in sin, you will find disfavor in the eyes of God. If you are living a life that is right, you will find favor in the eyes of God. And when you find favor in the eyes of God, God will always take steps to rescue you from whatever danger you may find yourself in. God will be with you. Noah found favor in the eyes of God. Are you laboring to have favor in men's eyes, or you are laboring to find favor in the eyes of God? People cover their lives, practice all sorts of falsehood, hypocrisy, because they are laboring in order to appease men. Noah did not find favor in the eyes of others. He found favor in the eyes of God. Set out that you will find favor in the eyes of God. And the Bible described that Noah was a righteous man. Noah was blameless. Noah walked with God, as we saw yesterday. So in a generation that is wicked, you can decide that you will be different. And then God told Noah what to do. Verse 11. Now the earth was corrupt in God's sight and full of violence. There was violence all over, corruption all over. People's lives were corrupt. Verse 12, God saw how corrupt the earth had become, for all the people on earth had corrupted their ways. Not some people, all the people. Are your ways corrupt before God? Are your ways corrupt before God? God saw, and God is a seeing God. If you are laboring to have this right relationship, this heart-to-heart, this loving relationship with God, you must be a person who will decide that all corruption in your heart, whatever has corrupted your ways, will be uprooted so that you will walk right with God. So that God will please with you. So that God can dwell in a heart that is not corrupt, is not defiled. A heart that says, I will be different. So the whole world had corrupted their ways. Everybody corrupted their ways. So God said to Noah, I am going to put an end to all people, for the earth is filled with violence because of them. And I'm surely going to destroy both them and the earth. Man brought judgment to the earth because of his ways. But we thank God. God had one person with whom he could discuss, and that was Noah. And God told Noah to make an ark. In verse 22, Noah did everything just as God commanded. He did everything just as God commanded. That's what it means to be obedient. He did everything as God commanded. Chapter 7, verse 1. Then the Lord said to Noah, go into the ark, you and your whole family, because I have found you righteous in this generation. God will step in to rescue the righteous. The righteous will be rescued by God. If you are walking right with God, God will rescue you. And the ark today is the Lord Jesus Christ, and God inviting you to enter into this ark, because there is judgment that is coming. There is judgment that is coming. God inviting every one of us, come into the Lord Jesus Christ, enter this ark so that you escape the judgment, and then walk right and maintain an intimate fellowship with me, so that the judgment I am bringing upon planet earth, you will not be judged along with the wicked. Have you entered the ark called the Lord Jesus Christ? Enter and be saved. Enter, walk right with God. Enter and live a life that will please the Lord.